getting my nails done. I'll show you guys when they're done. You gotta spend time on yourself and have self-love. It's important. So you guys, I just got back from the hospital. I've been really stressed out because my son has been taking this whole thing with his dad being away out on me. So we all need some me time, my friends. I don't care who you are. Self-love is important. And I got a really good discount from having my nails done here so many times before. I got a free nail thing today and I was sent a message. So I took it up on the offer. And look, I got a free gel nail. And I picked this color because I love it. It's the color of love. Isn't it pretty, you guys? I love them. So I'm excited. I love you guys. Have an awesome day. Be well. Stay meditated. Don't forget to hit the bell and a subscribe button so you don't ever miss out on a brand new video. And I'll speak with you guys again soon. Peace. Oh, little Sean, you just said your doctor is where? Right over here?
No.
Okay, down
like,
there.
I can suck a thing. I can suck my nose and go.
Do you like this hospital over here?
Yeah.
What about the doctor? You like your doctor? I thought you said you didn't.
Yeah.
Okay, now you do.
That
hospital's not a dumbass? Is that what you just said?
No, it's not.
Little Sean, we do not say those words, please.
But my daddy can't help it.
Help what? Your daddy can't help what?
A punk.
A punk.
A walrus.
Hey, my friends, and welcome back to the life of a spiritually awakened 40-year-old with a 3-year-old, and the husband father has been in the hospital for 8 weeks.
Hi.
What do you say? Hi. Oh my God, I love you guys. I started this channel when I was like in that really heightened state, right when you like have that intense spiritual awakening and it's like, oh my God, I know everything. Wow, this is so cool. You know that part? That's when I started this channel, and now it has turned into the journey of the middle part of it, because actually, my spiritual journey started in solitary confinement in one of the country's worst prisons. So, that's for another story. Anyway, you guys, I had to show up and let you know. This is awesome. Hold on 1 second, little Sean. This is awesome because...
Owie!
What's wrong? Well, be careful with your books. You're fine. Give mommy 2 minutes, please. I'm letting the people know the cool news. Okay, so Sean got it approved from his doctor to see his son today, which is super cool. I'm excited about it. So we're on our way there now so little Sean can see his dad. I'll be back. Stay tuned. Talking about God, I just need you, the source. Verse. doesn't like this song.
You want a different song? We're Daddy's Hospital.
Good.
me, you guys. What's your good news? And I will be back. You'll see it. We're not close to the hospital yet. In here because there's a lot of people in the hospital. So see how there's no parking spots? Mommy has to find a spot where we can park our car. No, those aren't parking spaces. Don't worry, we'll find one. Mommy usually just goes to the very top floor. And I just park up on the very top. Plus, it's easy because there's not a lot of cars up there. So, it's a lot easier when there's less cars and you don't have to worry about somebody else hitting your car. So, I actually like parking on the top floor and I park all the way at the other end, closest to the elevator. There's my spot. And I always have the same little parking spot. And mommy likes to park right here, buddy. That's normally where I park. All right. Yay, we made it. So you guys, this is awesome. Let's go see how Sean's doing. And little Sean is so excited. Little Sean, are you excited? Where are you?
Say hi.
Hi.
I'm going to see my daddy. For more videos. I don't know what he just said. I'll be right back, you guys. Hey, little Sean. Are you ready to go in the echo room?
Uh-huh.
Here we go, look.
Hi.
Say hello. This is what mommy does.
We are raising vibration. And the frequency.
Yeah. Yeah.
You hear how it echoes? Ooh, now we go in the elevator. Now look.
I'm on number one.
Wait, can you push number one?
Okay, yep.
Yep. Now wait for the door to close. Cool elevator, huh? It's little. Now we have to wait for the door to open. And you have to follow mommy, okay? And you have to listen. You want to hug daddy?
Yeah. Why are you stupid?
He says, little Sean says, I'm only wearing my mask because I want to see my daddy, right?
I want to see my daddy a second. Ooh, door.
Okay, come on. Let's go see daddy. Let's go. We got to go to that elevator down there. Oh my gosh, you guys, wish me luck. Send me tons of good energy.
Oh, Sean, let me see your fart machine. Do it louder.
Big fart.
Oh my gosh, you guys, that's so cool. A really awesome nurse gave him a toy. That's awesome. He's having the time of his life.
This helped me breathe.
Okay, little Sean, say bye. Little Sean. He doesn't care. What you doing? Go.
Oh, you can play.
Go again. Do a lap. Going pretty slow. There you go. Whoa.
You want to see my back one? Yep, watch it.
Ah, day in the life of a toddler. But he's excited. You can't wear it anymore?
Yep.
Are you comfortable?
Hey, I'm gonna put this on.
No, you gotta put your mask on, okay? Just lay on your pillow.
What? But freaks me out.
It freaks you out?
Uh-huh. But
the masks freak him out.
Huh?
The masks freak him out, baby. Look, we got cartoons. Are you going to lay down and watch them?
I thought you would watch them. Don't fall asleep. Hey, what's happening?
Going all the way to the top floor.
Yeah. Little Sean, did you have fun seeing Daddy today?
Uh-huh.
Hey, we got to let that close. Are you happy you got to see Daddy? And guess what? You can see Daddy more now, too. Isn't that cool? Yeah, I think that he's doing better.
Ooh. Oh my gosh.
You're blood.
Come on, let's go. That sounds safe.
Woohoo!
Okay, let's go. We gotta go, hurry up. Stay with mommy, our car's all the way down here. So you guys have a beautiful, blessed, and creative day. I am so grateful that my son was able to see his dad today. Sending you guys tons of love and gratitude from the Sunshine State. Gotta go, he's taken off. Peace. Unconditional love.
Lex, the producer, this off the air, was like, you know, I was explaining this to her, and I was like, you know, when I see
no conditions
your husband shows up after work, he comes in, he gives you a hug, gives you a kiss, I'm like, oh my gosh, you get a warm, fuzzy feeling back from him every time you, and I was like, with these, you know, this handful of relationships in my life, in all of them, it is God saying to me, I'm asking you to love that person, that person, that person. If nothing comes back to you, no personal benefit, no emotional warm fuzzy, it is just you loving them because that's what love is.
That's what love is.
And then this thought popped into my head of God saying, this is what I do with you. When you're unfaithful to me, you're rebellious, when you simply ignore me for chunks of time on end, I love you with a love you can't even understand, but I do it knowing nothing comes back to me. That's what God does for each and every one of us.
Yes. It's true.
And I stood there thinking, that is love right there.
That is love.
That the God of the universe can
have
a love.
That is unconditional love from God the universe.
Nothing in return. He gets nothing back. He simply loves me.
Love to just love.
And that helps in the effort. It helps in the effort of, okay, now it's my turn with this person, this person, and this person.
Yes.
To love when there's nothing in it for me.
Exactly. Love when there's nothing in it for
you. Ephesians 2:6 says this, but because of God's great love for us.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Woo! Yes.
I love you.
Good vibes happen on the tides.
That was so cool.
Not all stars belong in the sky. Thank you so much.
Oh, no problem.
You have an awesome, you have a great day too. We'll see you later. And I actually have that wallet. I love it.